my God, I loved it so much.
Beautifully told, beautifully written, and amazingly performed.
Sydney was awesome. This is just beyond awesome.
I enjoyed every minute of it.
I was completely blown away.
Smashed it.
Breathtaking.
Beautiful. Incredible.
Yes.
I'm buzzing, still buzzing.
So fun, so fun. Dream alone.
The band was absolutely fabulous. Somewhere.
David Campbell is a force of nature.
Astounding.
Such a fantastic voice.
He's a waste of talent on television. A girl to call
my own. I want a dream lover so I don't have to dream.
Highly recommend it.
Melbourne has to see it.
World class, world class.
You've got to come and see the show. You're mad if you don't.
Dream lover, come and see it.
Hi, welcome back to the Shtick. We've just seen an excerpt from the opening night of Dream Lover, and the person who co-wrote it, the show,
yes,
is the one and only
the Wilson. Yes. How are you, mate?
Franco.
Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you too.
As always.
You finally made it onto the Shtick.
I know. I had to change religion, and I had to, I had to go and wait on the wall, but I'm here, but I must say that I've always had a very deep, which you know, deep respect for the Jewish contribution to the entertainment business, and a show I wrote not that long ago with Warren Wills, Genesis to Broadway, it was basically a journey through the evolution of what became the American songbook from the very beginning, and its origins in the Jewish hymns, and how the American songbook is basically written by Jewish men.
Totally. Yeah. And we're here to talk about Dream Lover.
Yes, we are.
And not only that, but yourself.
Yes.
First of all, is one hell of a legend, what you have done and achieved in your lifetime, starting from the age of 7.
Yes, I know.
It, you were in theatre and you've written and directed and performed in movies.
Yes, I did 21 stage productions by the time I was 21, mainly for J.C. Williamson's, and I played Noddy in J.C. Williamson's production of Noddy at Her Majesty's Theatre.
That was your first ever appearance on stage.
That was my big appearance, yes. And the age, I'll always remember the review. In fact, I think I have it tattooed on my chest. The age said, Frank Howson makes a very appealing Noddy.
You still look like Noddy.
So it's all been downhill since then.
the show Dream Lover, though, is based on the life of
Bobby Darin,
the one and only.
An amazing man, a genius.
Mm.
Genius.
And some of the songs that are featured in the show,
yes,
were huge hits in the 60s, in the early 60s.
Yeah, a lot of people, it's a bit like the Jersey Boys with Four Seasons. A lot of people didn't. Think they knew Four Seasons until they went and saw Jersey Boys. They went, I love that song. And then the next song came on, I love that song. It's the same with Dream Lover.
Uh-huh.
You don't necessarily associate Bobby Darin with all those songs and those hits, but when you see the show, you come away going, this is the guy that sang the soundtrack of my youth. You know, he was an extraordinary man, a great songwriter, a great performer, a great musician.
Mm. Unfortunately, he died very young.
37.
At the age of 37. Before that, he'd been married to Sandra Dee.
Yes.
Who was in her own right a huge movie star at the time.
Yes, she was. She was. And it was love at first sight. And an extraordinary love story. In fact, Sandra Dee said, I don't know why we divorced. She said he just woke up one day and said he didn't want to be married anymore. He said, but looking back, I think maybe he knew the end was near with his health and he didn't want to put me through it. But she never remarried. She never went on another date.
She suffered from anorexia. She was a very sick lady.
Yes, yes. We addressed that, certain problems she had in her youth.
And several books were written about their life, or Bobby Darin more specifically.
Yes.
And one was by their son, Dodd Darin.
Yes, he wrote a very good book, the most authentic. But he was terrific. He came out to see the show when we opened in Sydney, and I saw him after the show, and he came down the stairs with tears in his eyes, very moved. And he walked up to me and he hugged me and he said, "You got every detail right." And he said, "All my life I've wanted a legacy for my father." Mm. And you've written
it. You've written it. Fantastic. And the person who plays Bobby Darin, we can't...
David Campbell. It is an extraordinary performance.
Because he is an amazing performer. He's wasting his talent on that TV show.
When you see what he does, I mean, this is the equivalent of Hamlet. When he plays Bobby Darin, he's virtually on stage the entire 2 hours and singing most of the songs. And he does it every night. And he's extraordinary.
Yeah, well, he's Jimmy Barnes' son, he's got a legacy there from his father, who's... A lot of people don't appreciate Jimmy's voice because it's something unique.
It is.
And I've seen Jimmy perform live, and every time I go, this guy is amazing.
Yes, he really is. Yeah, they have very good vocal cords, those guys.
Totally. And you met the manager of Bobby Darin.
Yes, yeah, Steve Blauner.
A nice Jewish boy.
He was a lovely man. And I met him when he was 82. Unfortunately, he died before we got the show on. But that meeting I had with him, which lasted most of an afternoon, we went through 3 bottles of wine together. And he told me all the stories. The relationship between him and Bobby in the show is very touching. Mm. And even though Steve was a very tough New Yorker, what I noticed that helped me write the character, every time he talked about Bobby to this day or to when I met him, he still teared up.
Mm. Because they had a very close relationship.
Yes, they did.
And Bobby Darin was also involved in the civil rights movement. He was a very passionate believer.
Yes, he campaigned for Reverend Martin Luther King. Bobby Kennedy was a dear friend of his. He was the first person to... He finally got, which was his ambition, to play top of the bill at the Copacabana.
Yes.
And he demanded that George Kirby, a black comedian, open for him. And the Copacabana said, no, it's against policy. No black performer has ever played here. And Bobby said, either the black kid opens or the white kid doesn't close. So
he's a mensch.
He is a mensch.
But he had chutzpah as well.
He did. You know, he did.
Tons of it. And talking about chutzpah, you've got an art exhibition at Fad Gallery.
At the Fad Gallery.
Yes.
At the moment.
Another one of your many talents. And it's been really wonderful to have you on the shtick. Finally, Frank Howson.
Thank you, mate. It's been a pleasure. And we didn't even touch the surface.
No, I know. This is what happens. We never have enough time.
Okay, I'll be back in 6 years.
We'll be back sooner.
Yeah, all right.
And we'll be back with more shtick next week. We're going out with just another little clip from the opening night.
Yes, it was amazing.
Amazing. And if anybody wants to see an incredible theatre performance...
It really touches people on a very deep level, the show. You come out of it in tears, crying over Bobby Darin. You love him. You love him.
And thank you so much, Frank.
Thanks, mate.
We'll be seeing you. And shalom.
Shalom.
I'm so thrilled about coming back to Melbourne and recreating the famous Summer Musical.
The Summer Musical has been well and truly embraced by Melbourne, and long may it continue.
If that light bulb's on the right page.
The audience were absolutely divine, and I feel like it was a great night.
They laughed, they cheered. We felt the spirit of the Darin family tonight, so we're here as an honour to them.